Okay, so like I said before, so we know that galvanometer it detects current, also ammeter. Tapi apa beza galvanometer dengan ammeter? Okay, kita tahu ammeter, okay, dia akan start daripada kosong kan? This is ammeter. Dia akan start daripada kosong and then dia akan bacalah the reading of the current. But galvanometer dia akan start daripada tengah. So dekat tengah ni ada akan jadi kosong and then 1, 2, 3, something like this. And then kalau deflection dia ke kanan, maksudnya direction of the current is going to the right. Kalau ke kiri, it will be going to the left lah ataupun opposite direction. So galvanometer ni dia akan start daripada tengah. So dia lebih tepat lah sebab dia akan tunjuk value dan juga direction. Compare to ammeter, ammeter just tunjuk value sahaja. So here we use galvanometer connected to the battery. Okay, so this galvanometer is connected to a jockey. So this one here is a jockey. We call it jockey. Okay, we call it jockey. Di mana jockey ni dia ada pointer. So this is a pointer. Okay, so apa function pointer ni? Dia akan point along the wire here. Okay, dia akan point at one point along the wire. So dekat sini Miss label sebagai point A dekat hujung, point B dekat hujung sini. So dekat wire ni, along this wire, there is one point. Okay, there is one point here. Okay, kita letaklah dia point C. Di mana point dekat point C ni, the galvanometer, this galvanometer will show no deflection. So dia tidak akan ke kanan atau ke kiri. So dia stay dekat tengah-tengah. Maksudnya there is no current. So the current will be equal to zero dekat point C ni. So when the current is equal to zero, maksudnya there is no current through the secondary circuit. Okay, current hanya akan ada dekat primary circuit saja. Dekat secondary circuit, there is no current. So from here, we can say that the voltage across A to C, voltage across A to C, pada point A ke point C, sebab point C inilah di mana point galvanometer tu dia tiada deflection. So voltage A to C will be equal to the value of the battery here. Okay, so the keyword untuk potentiometer dekat sini adalah no deflection. So when the question mentioned that galvanometer shows no deflection, maksudnya current will be equal to zero and the voltage across A to C, okay, depends lah pada gambar rajah tu. Adakah dia A, B di sini, tengoklah apa dia punya label. So, yang penting voltage across this point will be equal to the voltage across this battery. So, in this case, we can say that the potentiometer is balanced. Okay, potentiometer is balanced and we have reached a balance length. Okay, so untuk potentiometer ni, wait. Okay, untuk potentiometer ni, actually we have the experiment for this. Tapi kita tidak akan buat face to face dan kamu sudah buat the lab report for this experiment. Tapi kalau kita buat experiment, kita akan lebih nampak lah di mana dekat dalam experiment tu kita akan ada satu pointer ni. And then kita akan point dia along the wire. Maybe dekat point ni, Galvanometer masih ada lagi deflection, masih ada current. And then kita akan slide dia sampai dah satu point kita jumpa galvanometer tu sama dengan kosong. So bila dekat point tu, kita akan mark at that point and then kita akan ukur dia punya panjang panjang wire tu. Okay, so you just need to remember here, when the galvanometer has no deflection, the current will be equal to zero, and the VSC here will be equal to the unknown will be equal to the battery, the voltage of the battery here. Okay, so this for now, kita fahamkan this one dahulu, the typical potentiometer yang kita ada, di mana dia ada supply voltage, ada wire, and then kita ada battery, ada galvanometer. So this is the typical circuit for potentiometer. Okay, so basically, potentiometer ni apa function dia? The first function is to measure an unknown EMF of a cell. So basically, we want to measure the value here, actually. Usually we are not given. Okay, it depends on the question lah. But the first function is we want to find what is the value of the unknown voltage from the battery here. Second one is to compare the EMF of two cells. Okay, this one akan ada another circuit for it. We have EMF dan kita akan ada dua battery lah di sini. Tapi dekat typical here, we only have one battery. This one adalah supply voltage. And then last one, we want to measure the internal resistance of a cell. Okay. In the typical potentiometer, we don't have the internal resistance dekat sini. Tapi boleh jadi dekat battery tu ada internal resistance, and we are going to use the potentiometer concept to find that value of internal resistance. Okay, so far clear?
Clear, Miss.
Okay, so kita akan tengok the formula that we're going to use in this potentiometer. Okay, kita tengok the first case here, which is to measure the unknown EMF of a cell. Okay, so our aim here is to measure unknown EMF, di mana we want to find what is E2. So the aim here is to find E2. So this one sama macam yang tadi. The circuit is exactly the same macam yang tadi. But in order to find this E2, okay, since Miss cakap tadi apabila I sama dengan kosong, VSC akan sama dengan E2. So because our aim is to find E2, so we actually want to find VSC. Okay, so dekat sini kita akan gunakan the concept of potential divider. Okay, boleh someone bagi Miss what is the formula for potential divider?
V equals to R1 over R1 plus R2 times V.
Times V. So dekat sini adalah V1, right? Because if you want to find V1 here, so resistance dekat sini masihlah R1. And R1, R2 is basically the total resistance in the circuit and times with the supply voltage. So this one adalah voltage daripada power supply. Okay, so we are going to use this formula in potentiometer. Okay, so since we want to find is VSC, right? Basically, the voltage across this point. So our aim here is now to find VSC. So kita keluarkan ikut formula ni, di mana VSC will be equal to, since dekat sini satu, sini akan jadi satu. So sini VSC, di sini juga akan jadi RAC. And then divided by the total resistance. Okay, so Miss cakap tadi, along this wire from A to B, there will be a certain value of resistance, maybe 100 ohm. Okay, so maksudnya resistance kita ada di sini saja. So this will be the total resistance. Basically kita punya total resistance ni, in this case, is RAC plus RCB. So resistance daripada point A ke point C dan juga tambah dengan C ke B. So basically dia adalah resistance AB. It is resistance AB. So it will be divided by resistance AB and times with the okay, power supply, voltage from the power supply. So kita punya power supply adalah this one. E1. Okay, tapi dalam case ni Miss tidak mau gunakan E1 because nanti kita akan confuse. Instead of kita gunakan EMF, kita akan gunakan in terms of voltage V. Okay, so semalam Miss sudah explain. Okay, the voltage here across point, okay, let me label this one maybe point D and E. So the voltage across point A, point D and E akan sama dengan voltage across A and B. Okay, this one Miss explain kan semalam. Voltage across this point will be equal to voltage across this point. So, maksudnya di sini, E1 will be equal to the voltage across AB, from A to B. So, instead of kita gunakan E1, kita akan gunakan VAB. And then, kita akan rearrange this formula in terms of ratio. So kita rearrange, kita akan dapat VAB divided by VAC equal to RAB divided by RAC. So this will be the formula that we are going to use in potentiometer. Okay, so from here, dia senang je mahafal. So kalau kita mau VAB, dekat sebelah ni RAB, VAC divided by equal to RAC. Okay, so this one if you are given in terms of resistance. Okay, before this we learn that resistance is directly proportional to the length. Okay, resistance is directly proportional to the length. So kita juga boleh tulis the formula. VAB is equal to VAC equal to length AB is equal to length AC. Sebab dekat dalam potentiometer ni, usually kita akan dibagi in terms of the resistance ataupun in terms of the length. Macam yang Miss cakap tadi, usually the length will be equal to 1 meter. Okay, so here, kamu kena ingat dua benda, dua formula ni je. This one and this one in terms of resistance ataupun in terms of length. Okay, ataupun kita juga boleh keluarkan satu formula, satu ratio actually, di mana RAB divided by RAC will be equal to length AB divided by length AC. Okay, because we know that resistance is directly proportional to the length. So semakin panjang wire, semakin tinggi resistance. Okay, so these three formula kita akan gunakan di dalam potentiometer. Tidak kisahlah mana-mana case. Okay, so ni adalah untuk case yang pertama. Maksudnya because our aim is to find E2 and since we know that E2 is equal to VAC, so we can use this formula to find VAC. Ada soalan so far?
So far no question, Miss.
Okay, so kalau no question, let's proceed to the
Tiada, Miss.
Yes. Wait. Okay, so second case here, we have, we use the potentiometer to compare the EMF of two cells. So sekarang ni kita ada dua sel. So sama juga, we still have the primary circuit here di mana ada satu power supply dan ada satu wire AB. But in our secondary circuit, so this will be the secondary circuit, kita ada dua sel, dua battery. And we want to compare these two battery. Okay, so these two battery is connected to a to a galvanometer here, and then there is a switch. Okay. So if the switch kita connect dengan E1, okay, kita contohlah this switch is connected. Switch is connected to E1. So apabila dia connect dekat E1, so galvanometer ni hanya akan show deflection untuk E1 saja, dan dekat point C ni adalah point di mana the length of AC is balanced, meaning that here when the switch is connected to E1 and then galvanometer shows no deflection, I sama dengan 1, and then dia point ke point C. Maksudnya benda ni bukan serentak berlaku ya. Dia tidak, bukan kita ada dua joki, tidak. Kita hanya ada satu joki, tapi kita connect dengan ni dulu. And then apabila kita connect dengan ni, then kita akan point dekat point C. So apabila point dekat point C, maksudnya VSC akan sama dengan E1. Dan apabila kita connect dengan, we connect with the second EMF, E2. So the joki akan point dekat point D. Maksudnya VAD will be equal to E2. So we have another length here, length AD. So instead of kita compare dengan the power supply, kita akan compare kedua-dua ni. Sama juga macam tadi. Now we have VAC divided by VAD. So kita tidak sudah compare di bawah ni dengan E di atas, dengan power supply. So kita akan compare these two EMF. So VAC is equal to VAD will be equal to RAC divided by RAD, or if you want it to be in terms of the length, will be length AC divided by length AD. Okay, boleh faham so far? Are you guys clear with this?
Yes, miss.
Yes.
Okay, so kita ada dua case di sini. Dan this is usually the typical circuit for the potentiometer. Okay, tetapi bila kita tengok dalam example, dia akan berbeza. Maybe nanti dia akan tambah resistor dekat sini ataupun resistor dekat sini. So bila dia sudah tambah resistor di sini, dia sudah jadi, dia akan ubah sikit je lah. Dia bukannya akan ubah totally different. Dia akan ubah sikit. So kita akan tengok benda tu dalam example. Okay, so kita tengok example 26. Okay, so example 26. In the circuit shown on the left, the EMF of cell D is 2 volt with negligible internal resistance. The wire AB is 100 centimeter long and its resistance is 5 ohm. The EMF of cell X is 1.5 volt. Okay, so let's see what are the information that we are given here. So we have EMF D. This is EMF D with the voltage of 2 volt. And then kita ada wire AB. So wire AB is 100 centimeter. Okay, so we have the length AB is 100 centimeter, and then its resistance is 5 ohm. Maksudnya resistance daripada A ke B ni adalah 5 ohm. And then we are also given the EMF of cell X 1.5V. Okay, sekarang ni dia bagi pula the voltage here. So we are given EX is 1.5 volt, and then we are also given ED is 2 volt. Okay, now the first question, what is the balance length of AP when the galvanometer reading is 0? So we want to find the length here. Length from here, daripada A ke B. This is what we want to find. So apabila joki ni dia point dekat P, the galvanometer will be equal to 0. There is no reading, maksudnya apabila tidak reading, potentiometer is balanced. So potentiometer balance maksudnya kita akan dapat balance length here. So that is our M. We want to find LAP. Okay, so how do we find LAP? First step, kita keluarkan the formula. Okay. So formula adalah VAB. Okay, kena tengok dekat sini apa dia punya label. So VAB divided by VAP. And then seterusnya kita just follow length AB divided by length AP. So this will be the formula that we are going to use. Okay, before we proceed into substituting all of the value, sebab sekarang ni kita ada LAB, kita ada, this is our M, right? LAB kita ada, VAP, VAB, VAP, kita kena tentukan dahulu. Okay, so this one, kita hanya ada satu resistance dekat sini saja, dekat wire ni. Kita tiada external resistance dekat mana-mana, kita tiada. So kalau tiada, kita terus anggap VAP will be equal to E2. Macam yang Miss cakap tadi, the voltage across here will be equal to the voltage across this battery. Okay, bukan E2 lah, maksudnya EX, sorry. EX. And then the voltage across this two point will be equal to the voltage across this two point. Di mana kita ada 2 volt. So VAB will be equal to ED, which is equal to 2 volt. This one equal to 1.5 volt. Okay, before substitute, kamu kena make sure dahulu adakah betul VAP ni sama dengan EX. Macam mana mau make sure, kita kena tengok adakah do we have the external component? Adakah kita ada additional component sini? Kalau dia ada bagi resistance sini, okay, we need to consider that one. If we are given the resistance here, we need to consider that one as well. But if we are not given, we can terus assume that VAP sama dengan EX, VAB sama dengan ED. Okay, jelas?
Jelas, Miss.
Okay, so now sudah kita sudah tentukan this value. So kita boleh substitute into the formula, di mana VAB sama dengan 2 divided by 1.5 sama dengan length AB adalah 100 cm divided by length AP. So you will get length AP will be equal to, Seventy-five. What is the unit?
CM.
75 cm. Okay, so here we don't need to convert to meter. Okay, convert pergi meter pun, kalau tidak convert pun tidak apa. Kalau mau convert pun boleh. Sebab in the end nanti volt dekat sini dia akan cancel out juga. So in the end any unit that we are using, kita akan still dapat jawapan akhir menggunakan unit tu. So kalau dapat cm dekat sini, maksudnya dekat sini pun cm. If you use one here, which is 1 meter, so final answer must be in meter. Okay, ada soalan so far?
So far tiada soalan, Miss.
So far tiada soalan. Okay, so can I continue to the next one? Soalan B. Okay, here Soalan B, if a 1 ohm resistor is connected in series with cell D, what is the new balance length of AP? Okay, now kita punya circuit sudah ditambah satu resistor. So one resistor, 1 ohm of resistor which is connected in series with cell D. So ni cell D kita. So the resistor will be connected in series. So maksudnya dia dekat sini lah. Okay, there is a resistor here. So let's draw that one. So we have another resistor. Okay, yang lain still sama. So this will be ED, point A to B, this one point P, this one EX. And then this is the resistor with 1 ohm. And then soalan tanya, what is the balance, the new balance length? So M yang sama, we want to find what is the length of AP. Okay, so the step is still the same. Kita keluarkan dahulu formula di mana V AB is equal to VAP sama dengan LAB divided by LAP. Okay, now that we add a resistor here, apa value yang akan berubah selain LAP? Okay, LAP obviously dia akan berubah lah. What is another value that will change if we add the resistor here?
VAB.
So VAB akan berubah. VAB will change. Okay, kenapa dia akan berubah?
Sebab dia ada resistance dekat itu ED.
Okay, because tadi kan kita cakap the resistor across here, sorry bukan resistor, the voltage across AB will be the same with the voltage across here. Okay, so voltage dekat sini tadi berapa? 2 volt kan? Okay. Disebabkan ada resistor, so ada resistor bermaksud akan ada potential drop ataupun voltage drop. Maksudnya 2 volt dekat sini bukan semata-mata untuk AB saja. Okay, dia akan bagi kepada, dia akan bagi dekat resistor sini dan juga resistor dekat sini. So basically, okay, untuk lebih nampak lah. Basically kan, kita buat macam ni. So this is point B, ni point B, then this one point A, this one point P. Sini 2 volt kan tadi. So basically 2 volt ni, okay, basically 2 volt ni bukan semata-mata untuk dia bagi kepada AB saja sebab kita ada another resistor here. This is the resistor 1 yang tadilah. Resistor 1. So our voltage of VAB will change. So how do we find this voltage of AB? Anyone ada idea macam mana kita mahu cari VAB now? Because now VAB is no longer equal to 2 volt. Okay, let me call someone. Diana ada? Diana Sazatul Azlin. Diana, are you there? Okay, Hisham ada?
Ada ni.
Okay, Hisham, how do we find this value of AB?
Kalau guna EMF minus IR boleh tak?
Kalau guna apa dia? EMF
minus boleh tak?
IR, okay boleh. So VAB sekarang ni kita boleh gunakan, kita boleh cari menggunakan this formula di mana EMF minus IR. Okay, But now, okay, kita ada EMF. EMF kita adalah 2 volt. Okay, R kita ada, which is this one kan, tadi dia bagi 1 ohm. But we don't have the value for I. Okay, so remember that we learned yesterday, if we don't have the value for I, we have another method that doesn't require to find that value of I. What is that method? Okay, method apa yang kita gunakan kalau kita tidak perlu cari I lagi? We just learned it yesterday. Come on, guys.
Potential divider, Miss.
Yes, potential divider. Okay, sebab semalam Miss sudah mention kan? If we want to find voltage without finding the I, we can just use potential divider. Okay, bukan maksudnya salah. This one boleh juga. We can still use this one, but kita akan lebih banyak kerja. We need to find that I first. So, untuk straightforward, kita terus gunakan potential divider. Okay. Since we want to find the voltage across these two, so maksudnya VAB akan sama dengan RAB divided by RAB, which is total kan. Sekarang ni kita ada dua resistance. Resistance dekat along the wire plus another resistance. Maksudnya plus R1 times with the voltage supply. This one. Which is times with V1. So terus masukkanlah RAB tadi kita sudah dibagi, which is equal to 5 ohm divided by 5 times 1 times with the voltage, which is 2. So here will be equal to, okay, cuba kira dulu dapat berapa.
1.67 volt.
Okay, semua dapat 1.67 volt.
Dapat, Miss.
Okay. Okay, so this is the first method lah kita gunakan, potential divider. Okay, if we want to find using this method as well, okay, kita cari guna method ni, which is actually guna method Ohm's law. So if we want to find using Ohm's law, meaning that we need to find that value of I first. So how do we find that value of I?
V equals to IR, Kamis.
Okay, V is equal to IR. So V di sini adalah sama dengan?
2.
Sama dengan 2. And then R di sini adalah sama dengan?
1.
1?
5, kata Miss.
5? Okay, remember this one. Kalau di sini V, V ni adalah 2 kan? Basically, 2 ni adalah daripada the total voltage supply. Ni adalah voltage supply kita. So kalau dekat sini total, kita gunakan total, R juga mestilah the total resistance. Okay, so total resistance kita adalah this one. AB tambah dengan R1, which is sama dengan 6. Okay, jangan lupa tu lah. Kalau if you use the voltage here is the voltage from the battery, from the power supply, maksudnya itu adalah total voltage. So R dekat sini adalah total resistance. And then you will get the value for I, which is equal to
0.33
ampere. Lepas tu barulah kita boleh cari VAB, which is sama dengan 2 tolak 0.33 darab dengan 1. Then you should be able to get the same value lah. Okay, so this method dia panjang sikit lah because we need to find that value for I first and then barulah kita cari VAB. So kalau kita gunakan potential divider, kita terus dapat jawapan. So either way, still the correct way for you to find the value for VAB. Okay? Okay, so now that we have that value for VAB, So VAB dekat sini should be lebih rendah daripada supply voltage. Sebab dia sudah supply 2 voltage. And then 2 voltage ni dia bagi dekat sini, dia bagi juga dekat sini. So AB dia tidak akan terima 2 voltage. Must be lower than 2 voltage. Okay, masukkan 1.67 divided by VAP. Okay, VAP still the same. Since dekat circuit ni kita tiada tambah apa-apa resistance. So VAP still the same as EX, which is 1.5. Then length AB sama juga, dia tidak akan berubah. It is a fixed length divided by length AP. So length AP is what we want, which is equal to
89.82
centimeter. Semua dapat 89.82.
Dapat miss.
Dapat miss.
Okay, ada soalan so far?
No miss.
No, okay, jelas ah?
Jelas, jelas.
Okay, I will proceed to the next example, which is example 27. Okay, so here we have in the circuit shown on the left, the EMF of a cell E1 and E2 of the cells are 12 volt and 3 volt respectively. The internal resistance of cell E2 is 2 ohm. The wire PQ is 100 centimeter long and its resistance is 5 ohm. The balance length of AP is 60 centimeter. Calculate the internal resistance of cell E1. Okay, so let's keluarkan dahulu information yang kita dibagi. So here we have E1 sama dengan 12 volt. So this E1 equal to 12 volt, and then E2 is 3 volt. And then we are also given the internal resistance of cell E2. Okay, so E2 di sini dia ada internal resistance. Okay, kamu kena hati-hati sebab kadang-kadang dekat circuit dia tidak lukis pun that resistance here. Tapi dalam soalan dia bagi tahu, okay, ada internal resistance. Maksudnya we have another resistance here. R2 lah kita letak, which is equal to 2 ohm. And then the wire PQ is 100. Okay, dia bukan PQ, dia sebenarnya AB. So here it's not PQ, it's AB. The wire AB is 100 centimeter long and its resistance is 5 ohm. So AB adalah sama dengan 100 centimeter. Resistance is 5 ohm. And then we are also given the length, the balance length is 60 centimeter. Now calculate the internal resistance of cell E1. Okay, maksudnya dekat E1 ni akan ada juga internal resistance. So there's internal resistance on as well. So our M is to find R1. Okay, so here sama macam yang tadi sebenarnya, tapi yang tadi kita tiada internal resistance, now we have internal resistance. Okay, so first thing you need to do, keluarkan formula. Okay, always start with, kita keluarkan formula. VAB is equal to, divided by VAP, sama dengan length A. AB divided by length AP. Okay. Since kita ada this value, right? LAB, LAP. And our M is to find R1. So R1 di sini adalah dekat primary circuit. Bermaksud, we actually need to find that value of VAB. Okay, sebab kenapa? Kalau kita keluarkan formula yang tadi kan, di mana VAB adalah sama dengan E minus IR. So EMF tolak dengan the voltage drop across the internal resistance. So basically, in order to find R1, we need to find VAB first. And then VAP, okay. So now, dekat bawah ni, dekat secondary circuit ni, ada another internal resistance. Okay, tetapi internal resistance di sini, we can ignore. Okay, we can ignore that internal resistance. So, if we ignore the internal resistance, meaning that VAP masih juga sama dengan E2. Sebab sekarang ni, there is no current here, right? Tidak akan ada current. Sebab dia satu kali macam ni je. Terus pergi galvanometer. So, there's no current. So, there's no voltage drop across this internal resistance. That's why VAP kita terus sama dengan 3 volt. Okay. So our aim here is to find this VAB. So you just masukkan VAB divided by VAP is equal to 3 volt. So this one equal to 3 volt equal to length AB. And then length AB is 60 centimeter. So VAB will be equal to
5 volt,
right?
5, miss.
Okay, thank you. 5 volt. Semua dapat?
Dapat, miss.
Okay. So now that we have VAB, we can find the value for this internal resistance. This is what we want, internal resistance 1. Okay. So in order to find this internal resistance, we need to find I as well. Sebab kita ada VAB 5 volt, E dekat sini adalah E1. So this one should be E1. E1 kita ada, which is 12 volt. R1 is what we want to find. And now we need to find that I first. Okay, so this one sama juga macam yang tadi. We can either use potential divider or Ohm's law. So kalau kita gunakan potential divider, we don't need to find the I. If we want to find using the Ohm's law, we need to find the I first. Okay, so kita akan buat dua-dua method. First, we use potential divider. Okay, so macam mana kita mau keluarkan that formula untuk potential divider from this circuit? Can someone tolong keluarkan formula untuk potential divider based on this circuit? Coba let me call someone. Ivy ada? Ivy? Ivy dia ada. Alicia ada? Nur Alicia. Okay, Diana? Diana, are you there?
Yes, miss.
Okay, Diana, can you help me to keluarkan formula untuk voltage divider based on this circuit?
Miss, I'm not very sure about this, but let me try. 12 over 3 plus 12.
12 over 3 plus 12.
Eh bukan, 12 plus 2 over 3 plus 12.
Oh, over 3 plus 12. Wait, kejap lah guys. I think someone is outside. Sorry, jap. Okay, sorry ya. Ada pasal pula tadi. Apa apa dia tadi, Dayana? 12 divided by 3 plus 12 equal to?
Miss times.
Times.
Times with 3. Miss.
Sekejap, sorry, boleh ulang semula. Okay, Miss padam dulu. Okay, apa dia?
12 over 12 plus 3 times with 3.
Times with 3. So we will get R1 lah here. Which is 12 ni, so basically aku mau cakap 12 ni adalah E1. Divided by E1 plus, what is 3? E2. Times with E2, like that. Is that? What are you trying to point? Betul kan ni?
Miss, bukan resistance-nya 5 kah?
Resistance dia 5 kan? So, daripada mana dapat 3? Okay, so okay, nice try, Diana. Thank you for your effort. Okay, because we want to use the potential divider method, right? So the potential divider, since kita sudah ada the value for VAB kan, because we want to find R1, and then R1 ni kita boleh dapatkan daripada VAB. So kita keluarkan formula potential divider untuk VAB. Okay, VAB sama dengan will be RAB, and then di bawah bahagi dengan the total resistance. So total resistance kita adalah RAB. Okay, dekat circuit primary ni kita ada dua resistance. Satu resistance ni, satu lagi this one. Tambah R1 times with E1, the supply voltage. This is the supply voltage. Okay, biasakan apabila kamu mau selesaikan soalan kan, biasakan keluarkan dahulu formula tu. Jangan terus masukkan that value. Actually, in the end nanti kamu tidak tahu value ni daripada mana sebenarnya. What value tu, value apa? Adakah dia value voltage, adakah dia length ataupun resistance. Okay, so biasakan you keluarkan that formula dahulu, barulah kita masukkan that value. So the our aim here is now to find this R1. And then you just masukkanlah that value yang kita tahu. So VAB kita sudah ada. RAB pun kita sudah ada 5. Plus R1 and then times with E1. E1 tadi adalah supply voltage 12. Barulah kamu akan dapat the value of internal resistance, which is equal to
seven ohm kan?
Berapa dia?
7 ohm.
7 ohm, yes. Yang lain dapat 7 ohm?
Dapat, Miss.
Dapat, Miss.
7 ohm. Okay, so the trick here is you need to identify first what is it that you want to find. Since you want to find R1, dan R1 ni kita dapat daripada mana? Kita actually boleh dapat daripada VAB. So daripada formula ni, sebab dekat formula asal ni, there is no R1. Okay, there is no R1, there is no value of resistance as well. So maksudnya kita boleh dapatkan satu value dahulu, which is value VAB. Dan daripada VAB, kita boleh dapatkan that R1. So kita boleh guna dua method. Satu adalah guna method this one, potential, Ohm's law, di mana we need to find that value for I first, or we can use the potential divider since kita sudah dapat that value of 5 volt, which is untuk voltage untuk AB, then you just keluarkanlah VAB sama dengan apa. Okay? So next one, kita akan tengok how can we use the potential, the Ohm's law method. So number two, we use Ohm's law. di mana yang tadi itu VAB sama dengan E minus I R1. So our M is to find R1 and then we need to find I first. So how do we find I since circuit ni adalah series. It is a series circuit. Maksudnya current yang lalu AB akan sama dengan current yang lalu R1, which is sama dengan the total current. So that I value will be the same. Maksudnya V total akan sama dengan I total times with R total. So V total kita adalah 12. 12 kan? Is it 12? Betul ke 12?
Ya,
okay, 12. I total is what we want to find. R total. So total resistance dalam circuit tu. Okay, this one merujuk kepada the first circuit. So ada dua resistance, AB dengan R1. So kita kena totalkan dalam dua ni. Di mana satu 5. Satu lagi. Okay, wait. Okay, this one we cannot use sebab we want to find that R1, right? So we cannot use this one. So instead of using this one, there's another one that we can use. Okay. So kita tidak boleh gunakan total sebab dekat total kita ada RAB dan R1 kan? But we want to find that R1. So we cannot use this one. So instead of this one, kita boleh gunakan VAB. Sebab VAB kita sudah ada the value. Di mana VAB akan jadi sama dengan IRAB. VAB kita dapat which is 5 volt times with I times with RAB. So I kita akan sama dengan 1 ampere. So this one we cannot use this one. So since kita sudah dapatkan I1, so I1 ni kita boleh dapatkan daripada this one lah. So now kita boleh dapat that value of I. 5 is equal to 12 tolak 1 R1. So should be kamu akan dapat 7 ohm juga. Okay, cuba kira. Kamu akan dapat 7 ohm. 5 tolak 12. Itulah.
Dapat miss.
Okay, betul kan dapat 7 ohm. Okay, so basically untuk potentiometer ni dia sama aja. Dia punya method. First thing you need to do, okay, kalau macam biasalah kita keluarkan formula dahulu. Kita keluarkan dulu information yang ada, apa yang information yang kita dibagi, adakah kita ada internal resistance or not. And then barulah kita keluarkan formula. Dan formula kita always in terms of like this. Kita gunakan V instead of E. Okay, kita tidak gunakan E. Dalam nota kamu, okay, Miss tidak edit lagi dalam nota kamu tu. Dalam nota kamu dia in terms of E. Okay, dia bukannya dia salah tapi dia senang untuk kamu buat kesilapan. So instead of kita guna E, kita gunakan V. Okay, instead of that one, kita akan gunakan V1, V2. Actually the general formula is V1, V2, L1, L2 lah. Tapi di sini sebab kita sudah label A, P, B ni, so we use the alphabet instead of the number. So always start with this one, this formula first, and then okay, this one usually memang akan dibagi. This one usually akan dibagilah the fixed length, and then you identify whether VAB equal to 1. Adakah VAB tu dia equal to E1 saja ataupun dia kena tolak lagi? Okay, ada kena tolak maksudnya kalau ada another resistor here, there is another voltage drop. And then VAP pun sama. VAP, okay, kalau dia satu line macam ni kan, dia satu line macam ni and then ada resistor, we can ignore that resistor. Maksudnya we can ignore there is no potential drop. Okay, lepas sudah kita identify that all of that value, okay, barulah masukkan. Okay, dia kena buat step by step. Jangan kelangkabut, most softkan. Okay, potentiometer ni adalah satu topik yang quite tricky actually, but if you do it step by step, okay, insyaAllah kamu boleh solvekan lah. Ada soalan so far? Semua jelas?
Jelas, Miss.
Okay, kalau jelas, kita akan bincang soalan tutorial. Which is soalan 10. So, ada satu saja soalan potentiometer dekat dalam soalan tutorial kita. Okay, so far, potentiometer ni dia tidak pernah tanya lagi dalam PSPM. Sebab satu, potentiometer ni dia susah actually. It's not that susah, but it's quite tricky lah. And because untuk chapter 3, okay, so chapter 3 ni adalah chapter yang panjang kan. Kita ada 9 subtopik. And then kita ada Kirchhoff law, kita ada potential divider. Okay, Kirchhoff law sendiri dia memang tu je method dia. Kita tidak campur dengan benda lain kecuali Ohm's law lah. And then potential divider dengan potentiometer adalah satu subtopik. Maksudnya dia boleh buat dalam satu soalan. So, dia tidak boleh tanya banyak soalan dalam dalam PSPM because chapter 3 ada banyak subtopik. So, sebelum-sebelum ni past year dia banyak tanya Ohm's law and Kirchhoff law. Belum pernah lagi tanya potentiometer lah. So, we don't know kan macam mana nanti dalam exam adakah dia akan tanya potentiometer. So, kamu mesti juga kena mahir dalam solvekan soalan macam ni. Okay, so kita tengok soalan nombor 10. Okay, so here we have PQ is a potentiometer wire of length 100 centimeter. So PQ here, 100 centimeter. Accumulators X and Y have the same EMF and negligible internal resistance. So kita ada accumulator X and Y where they have the same EMF. And we can neglect that internal resistance inside this battery. So there's no internal resistance. Okay, if the galvanometer shows zero deflection, what is the equilibrium length of the circuit? Equilibrium length, balance length, it's the same thing. Maksudnya, bila dia point, dia pointkan dekat sini, joki ni. So kita letaklah this one point, point A lah di sini. Bila dia point je kepada point A, the galvanometer shows zero deflection. So it shows zero deflection. So we want to find what is the value of L here, the balance length. Okay, first of all, kita keluarkan information yang kita dibagi. We are given the length of PQ is equal to 100 centimeter. And then we are also given that EMF X and Y has the same value, but we are not given that value. So kita tulis saja EX sama dengan EY. And what we want to find is the length. So kita sudah letak A di sini, maksudnya LPA is what we want to find. Okay, first, macam biasa keluarkan that formula of V PQ. Okay, kita gunakan PQ, this one. Dia mesti V yang along the wire. Okay, mesti sampai hujung lah, dia tidak boleh dekat sini. VPQ divided by VPA. And then is equal to length PQ divided by length PA. And this is what we want to find. Okay, length PQ kita ada VPQ dan VPA. Okay, we need to identify dahulu. Adakah VPQ sama dengan EX ataupun tidak? Okay, so from here, VPQ sama dengan, adakah dia sama dengan EX? Ataupun kita kena tolak lagi? Anyone?
Dia boleh ignore ke to miss dia punya resistance?
Okay, sebab dekat sini sudah disebutkan negligible internal resistance. So maksudnya kita boleh ignore lah the resistance. So VPQ will be equal to
EX.
VPA.
VP, EX, bukan VPA. VPQ, the voltage across these two point will be equal to the voltage across this point. Since dekat this point kan, along this point from here to here, there is no resistance. Actually, ada resistance tapi kita neglect, dia cakap negligible internal resistance. So, kalau tiada, kita terus ambil VPQ sama dengan EX. VPQ sama dengan EX. Okay, tapi kita tiadakan value EX. It's okay, kita keluarkan that information first. And then, VPA pula. Okay, so VPA here. Is VPA will be equal to EY?
No. No.
Tidak, miss.
Tidak. Okay. So kalau tidak, dia akan equal to what?
EY minus IR.
EY minus IR. Okay. So kita, okay, this one is EY kan? R dekat sini adalah which R? Adakah this one, or this one, or all of them?
All of them.
All of them.
All of them? Are you sure?
Yang R saja akan miss.
Okay, yang ni saja sebenarnya. Okay, sebab kenapa? Okay, here. Okay, kalau miss lukis this secondary circuit saja. Let me lukis this one first. So here kita ada two resistor. And kita ada EMF. And then kita ada resistor ni kan dekat tepi. Okay. And then galvanometer tu dekat sini. Okay, because we want to find VPA. VPA tu adalah between this point and this point. Actually, dia adalah parallel between this point and this point. Also parallel between this point and this point. Okay, ni letaklah. CD EF. So point PA parallel dengan point CD parallel dengan point EF. Maksudnya voltage across this one will be equal to across this one will be equal to across this one. So from here you can see that VPA is actually equal to the voltage across this two point only. Di mana kita ada dua resistor sahaja. Bermaksud di sini, okay, let me put like this. This one is, kan is Y, right? So here will be VPA. So VPA akan sama dengan the voltage across this one. So kita keluarkan that voltage across that one will be equal to will be equal to IR, right? IR total, di mana total dekat sini kita ada dua saja. I, so ada dua, lima, enam lah. Which is also equal to the voltage across this point to this point. Actually, daripada point ini sebenarnya kita boleh letak, okay, ni letaklah dia di bawah. Actually, dia pun sama aja sebenarnya kalau kita letak dia di bawah. It's still between the point here. Okay. So VPA akan sama dengan the voltage drop across this two point. Di mana across this two point kita ada EMF. Dalam EMF tiada voltage drop sebab dia lah yang supply voltage. So dia kena tolak dengan IR. Boleh nampak ke the relationship between this resistors. Ada yang tidak jelas?
Miss, boleh explain ke kenapa RT equals to 6R?
Okay, on this one. Okay, because tadi Miss cakap VPA kan? VPA is this one here. The voltage across this one dia akan sama dengan the voltage across this CD. Because they are parallel. So along this CD, we only have two resistor and they are in series. So VPA akan sama dengan IRCD. Actually, point dekat sini dengan dekat sini. Di mana daripada point dekat sini ada 2, so kita total saja. Which is 5R plus R, so you will get 6RI. Macam tu. Boleh?
Okay, Miss Panda.
Okay. So, okay, kita sudah dapat keluarkan this one, which is daripada point sini ke sini. And then kita keluarkan lagi dekat daripada point sini ke sini. So, daripada point sini ke sini ada satu saja voltage drop dekat this resistor. And then, dekat bateri dia tiada voltage drop. Maksudnya, bateri ni dia supply voltage ke sini. That's why kita kena tolak. EY tolak the voltage drop across this resistor. Okay? Semua boleh? Semua boleh follow? Ada soalan
lagi?
Boleh, Miss.
Okay, so lepas tu, kita sudah keluarkan this information kan? Then kita masukkanlah in here. VPQ, okay wait. Kita sudah dapat VPL lah, di mana VPL akan sama dengan this one. Okay, now VPQ sama dengan EX. Dan EX sama dengan EY. EX sama dengan EY. So, kita kena cari EY sekarang ni. So, daripada sini kita boleh cari EY. From here, we can find EY. Let me put it here first. Okay, just susun saja di mana EY adalah sama dengan VPA plus IR. Dan VPA is this one. I6I plus IR. Meaning that you will get 7RI. Okay, boleh follow?
Boleh, Miss.
Boleh, Miss.
Okay. So, sudah dapat EY. EY adalah sama dengan EX, which is sama dengan VPQ. So, VPQ kita adalah sama dengan this one. VPA akan sama dengan this one. Okay. So, now kita substitute. Wait. Lama. Mana mau letak ni? Okay, so EY sama dengan 7RI. And then VPA, this one sama dengan 6RI. And then you just substitute that one since we don't have that value. Betul ke VPQ? Wait, let me check first. Okay, kita substitute dulu tengok dapat ke tidak. So LPQ is 100 divided by LPA. And then LPA dapat berapa? This one kita boleh cancel. Okay, betul lah. 85.7 centimeter. Semua dapat 85.7 centimeter.
Dapat ni.
Dapat ni.
Ada dapat soalan ni. So far? Yang lain? Okay, kalau tiada soalan boleh Miss proceed to the next one.
Boleh Miss. Boleh Miss. Okay.
Let me proceed to the next question, question B. Okay, so question B, the connection of the galvanometer is modified as shown in figure. How should the jockey be adjusted for the galvanometer to have zero reading. Okay. First of all, okay, kita ignore saja benda ni. Basically, what we want is this value of L. Okay, kita ignore dulu sebab macam susah sikit mau faham. So, still the same thing that we need to find, which is that value of L, that reading. Because they mean that how should the jockey should be adjusted, right? Okay, so our M is the same. We want to find the L. So this one A kan tadi? LPA is what we want to find. Okay, sekarang ni, that connection is change. So tadi galvanometer tu dia connect dekat sini kan? Now dia connect dekat bawah. So basically, okay, kalau Miss lukis semula. Okay, kalau Miss lukis semula this diagram. Untuk kamu lebih nampak lah. Basically, kita akan ada tiga resistor in series. Okay, basically, so this connection is here. They're connected to the battery. So, macam dia, bila Miss lukis tu dekat sini lah. Dia terus pergi battery and then these three resistor are in series. So, tiga resistor in series. Basically, it's the same circuit. Miss just letak dia satu baris lah supaya kamu lebih nampak. Okay. So, first thing first, you keluarkan formula. So benda lain still sama, tiada yang berubah, just the connections, connection of the galvanometer. Okay, so kita keluarkan V PQ divided by VPA sama dengan LPQ divided by LPA. And this is our M to find LPA. Okay, now that the connection is changed, meaning that value untuk VPQ dan VPA. Okay, bukan. VPQ is still the same. VPQ masih sama. Sebab dia ubah di bawah je, di atas dia sama. So, maksudnya tadi VPQ kita berapa? This one. Okay, dia adjust connection yang di bawah dekat secondary. Okay, so our VPQ is still the same. VPQ sama dengan 7RI. Okay, now yang berubah adalah VPA. So, sekarang ni, can someone tell me what is the VPA now? Will be equal to what?
7RI.
Apa dia, Brian?
7RI.
7RI, yes. So, sekarang ni VPA kita akan sama dengan 7RI sebab VPA here will be equal to the voltage across this one. So sekarang dekat between these two point kita ada tiga sudah resistor dan bila kita total resistor ni akan jadi 5R plus R plus R, you will get 7R and since because V is equal to IR, our total right, so kita akan dapat this one. Okay, boleh nampak yang lain macam mana dapatkan that value?
Boleh Miss.
Okay, so now
wow.
Are you okay? Darren, ada apa-apa mau tanya?
Oh, tidak, Miss.
Okay. So, now kita sudah dapat, we can just substitute 7RI. 7RI is equal to 100 divided by LPA. Maksudnya LPA kita sekarang ni adalah 100 centimeter. Okay, so this is LPA. Actually, soalan tu apa yang dia minta? Dia akan minta, so this one you can just like, you know, cancel all of them. So basically apa yang dia minta adalah how should the jockey be adjusted for the galvanometer. So initially, jockey ni dekat sini, dekat A. Which is berapa ya tadi yang kita kira the first The first answer 85.7 kan?
85.7.
Okay, yes, 85.7. Initially dia dekat point ni. And then bila dia sudah connection galvanometer ni kita ubah ke sini, so dekat point point ni dia tidak sudah jadi I sama dengan kosong. I is no longer equal to zero sebab kita sudah ubah dia ke sini. Maksudnya kita kena adjust lagi sampailah kita jumpa at one point that galvanometer will show no deflection. Maksudnya kita akan slide dia sampailah kita jumpa. So basically apa yang kita jumpa adalah dekat point Q. Dia dekat point Q barulah barulah that galvanometer shows no deflection. Sebab dia cakap tadi bila dekat, bila balance, the length is actually 100 cm. Okay, so basically it is here. So how should we adjust it? Maksudnya kita kena adjust to the right by 100 minus 14.3 cm. So the jockey should be adjusted to the right. Okay, according to this circuit lah. It should be adjusted to the right by 85.7, sorry, by 14.3 cm.
Miss.
Yes.
Wajib letak tu nilai kan? Tak boleh kita sebut joki tu di move to Q point.
Tidak, dia mesti letak nilai. Mesti letak nilai sebab it's physics, right? So you need the value.
Okay, miss.
And then satu lagi sebab dia basically dia minta, actually it doesn't really say the exact word yang dia minta value kan. So to be safe, we always include the value of that that thing that we need lah. Okay, so you can say here jockey. Okay, actually it's not necessary untuk tulis tapi untuk buat kamu lebih faham. Jockey should be adjusted to 14.3 cm from initial point. Okay, di mana? This one is just nota lah. Di mana initial point? Initial point adalah at point A, which is 85.7 cm. Okay, ada soalan so far?
Tiada, miss.
Semua jelas?
Tiada, miss.
Jelas,
miss.
Jelas,
miss.
Okay, so kalau jelas, ada satu soalan lagi semalam kita belum sempat bincangkan, soalan tutorial, which is soalan tutorial number 5 here. Okay, before kita tengok soalan number 5 ni, okay, yang semalam yang Miss KIV tu, which is the about the energy. Okay, so semalam, okay, this question number 4 here. Okay, so semalam we want to find the what is the thermal energy dissipated from the cell and also dissipated from the circuit. Okay, so daripada cell kita akan gunakan this formula, right? Di mana E is equal to IVT. Okay, dan V di sini semalam is confused which V that we need to find. So V di sini adalah voltage across internal resistance. Sebab energy can only be dissipated through resistor. Maksudnya energy loss ni dekat resistor saja. Dekat bateri tidak akan ada. Dekat dalam, because dekat dalam cell ni kita ada, this is the cell, right? Kita ada internal resistance. Dan since dia minta untuk cell je, dan energy dissipated is only through the resistor, that's why V dekat sini adalah V in the resistor only, which is why kita kira this one. V is equal to IR. Dan R dekat sini adalah I resistor. Okay, but if we want to find the energy dissipated from the external circuit, So external circuit basically is a component selain daripada the cell. So this is the cell. Selain daripada cell tu, yang di luar daripada cell tu adalah external circuit. Okay, so dalam soalan ni dia tidak bagi tahulah ada the component, ada component actually. Tapi kita boleh assume that along the wire there is a resistance. So bila dekat external circuit,
Miss,
Hi, Azmi.
Macam sudah ni kemarin, nomor 5 yang belum.
I just want to clarify.
Okay. Okay.
So bila dekat external circuit, this one here, that's why bila kita mau kira untuk external circuit kan E is equal to IVT. So V di sini adalah V is equal to E minus IR. Sebab dekat external circuit dia akan ada voltage drop. Kamu just ingatlah benda tu. Kalau dekat cell, you just use the voltage here. External circuit, so anything yang dekat luar. So dekat luar sebenarnya V is equal to E minus IR. Okay, jelas? This one yang semalam lah yang just need to clarify that value daripada mana kita dapat. Okay?
Jelas, Miss.
Soalan? Kalau tidak soalan, I will continue with number 5. Okay, soalan tutorial number 5. Okay, so here we have the circuit. Okay, we have the circuit 10 volt of battery connected to 3 resistor. And then it is given here the power dissipated by heat by the 4 ohm resistor is 4 watt. So 4 ohm. Maksudnya power dekat power loss dekat sini je. So we are given that the power dissipated at, okay, kita label lah dahulu R1. R2. So the power dissipated through resistor 1 is equal to 4 watt. Okay, first of all, what we need to find is what is the value of resistance of resistor R in the circuit. So we are not given the value here and we need to find what is that value. So that is our M, the first question. What is the value for the resistance? Okay, so how do we find this value? First of all, apa yang kita kena cari dahulu in order to find that value of R?
Current.
Apa dia?
Current ke, Miss?
Current?
Yes.
Okay, so you say we need to find the current first. Okay, so how do we find the current?
V equals to IR.
Okay, we need to find the, okay, so the first step you said we need to find I first using V is equal to IR. Okay, so what value that we need to include, we need to substitute to here and here.
V sama dengan 10.
V sama dengan 10. And then R.
Dan
okay, tak dapat kan? Because yeah. if we want to use V sama dengan 10 kan, maksudnya kita gunakan total. Maksudnya dekat sini pun akan jadi total. Tapi kita punya total, kita tidak dapat cari because we have unknown value here. So basically maksudnya dekat sini, we need to find that R total in order to find that value for R. So our M is to find R total. Okay, so how do we find that R total? We will use that V is equal to IR. This one and this one. But before that, we need to find the I1 first. Okay, daripada mana kita dapatkan I ni, since kita tidak boleh gunakan Ohm's law, kita sudah dibagi satu information. Apa information yang kita dibagi?
Power.
Power.
The value of power. So daripada power ni, keluarkan apa formula untuk power?
V square over R.
V square over R. Okay. Okay, so since kita ada power, power dekat sini bukan power throughout the circuit ya. Dia adalah power through this resistor only. So dia cakap power dissipated by as heat by 4 ohm resistor. Maksudnya dekat sini sahaja. Maksudnya the value for R here is this value. Okay, P kita ada 4 watt. So what is the value for V? We cannot use this formula because we need to find that V pula. There is another formula untuk power. What is that formula?
I square R.
Boleh guna.
I square R, right? Because our M is to find I. So that I dekat sini kita boleh masukkan di sini. So the M is to find I. So keluarkanlah formula yang ada I. So here maksudnya P1. So here will be R1. Maksudnya sekarang ni kita boleh kira the I across the resistor number 1. So P tadi 4. I square R1 is 4. So kita boleh dapat I will be equal to 1 ampere. Maksudnya the current across this the current across this resistor will be equal to 1 ohm. So basically sebabkan this one adalah series dengan this two, right? Actually kalau kita simplify ia akan jadi series lah kan kalau kita simplify. So basically that I value is actually the total value. So this I1 is also the total current. Okay? So now that we have that total current kita boleh masukkan di sini. So here V total is equal to I total times with R total. V total kita 10, I total 1, R total. Kita akan dapat R total adalah sama dengan 10 ohm. So untuk mendapatkan that R total, which is semua ni lah kan. Maksudnya basically this one adalah benda yang terbalik lah. Kita, we do it backwards. So instead of kita cari total resistance dahulu, kita kena cari benda yang apa yang ada dahulu, apa yang dibagi dulu in order to find that total resistance. Sebab tipikal soalan, kita mesti cari total resistance dulu kan? Selalu soalan Ohm's Law mesti cari total resistance dahulu. Tapi sekarang ni kita tiada maklumat yang lengkap untuk that resistance. So kita, we do it backwards. Kita buat dia terbalik. Okay, so here, this one is R1, this one actually R2, 3 lah. So, ni gunakan 3. So, the total current, sorry, the total resistance adalah sama dengan 10 ohm. So, kita boleh dapatkan R2, 3. Di mana R1 adalah 4. So R2, 3 is equal to 10 minus 4. Kita akan dapat 6 ohm. So one will be 6 ohm. Lepas tu since R2, 3 ni dia adalah parallel. So keluarkanlah formula untuk parallel, which is di mana R2, 3 is equal to 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. And then sini kita dapat 10. 1 over R2 tadi berapa? 8 plus 1 over R3 is what we want. So kamu akan dapat R3 dah sama dengan
24
ohm. Semua dapat?
Miss, yang R2 3 tu bukan 6 ohm kah?
Bukan apa?
R23 itu bukan 6 ohm kah?
Oh, 6, yes.
Ya, Miss.
This one here. 6. Kan? So, sini 6, 8, 24. Dapat kan? Is it? Okay. Ada lagi yang silap? Okay, boleh Miss continue to the next one?
Boleh Miss.
Okay, so next question. We want to find what is the current passing through resistor R. So we want to find what is the current passing through this resistor. What is I3? How do we find I3? Okay, first, so let me be right. So M is to find I3. So basically I3 ni kita boleh dapatkan daripada V3 is equal to I3, R3. So R3 kita sudah ada. In order to find I3, we need to find V3. So our M first is to find V3. So how do we find V3? From here. Anyone
EMF, ada idea? EMF tolak IR.
EMF. EMF tolak IR satu, R satu.
Ya, R yang dibuat tu.
V3. Okay, so EMF kita tadi 10 tolak. What is the I here? This value for I is 1, is it? So because kamu cakap R1 kan? So I yang to the first one lah, I. Oh sorry, 1. Then R1 is 4. So kamu akan dapat sama dengan V3. So what is V3?
6 volt.
6 volt. Okay, so sudah dapat V3, we can find that value for I3. 6, I3, R3 tadi 24. So I3 will be equal to
0.25 ampere.
Okay, so kalau kamu tidak menggunakan this method, we can also use the method of potential divider. So again, potential divider, since because tadi kita mau cari V3 kan, V across this 3, resistor number 3. Since V across here will be equal to the V across here. So kalau kita gunakan potential divider, sebab potential divider dia punya syarat dia mesti series circuit. So from here, V23 akan sama dengan V3 sama dengan V2. So boleh gunakan potential divider lah untuk dapatkan that value. Maksudnya, if we use potential divider, V23 akan sama dengan R23 plus R1 times V. So R23 kita tadi 6. 6 tambah dengan R1 4 and then voltage 10. So kamu akan dapat 6 volt. Okay, so either way it's still the same. You will get the same answer. Okay, so last one. We want to find how much time will it take for 75 joule of energy to be dissipated from resistor R. So kita punya M adalah kita fokus pada this resistor number 3. We want to find what is the time. So we want to find what is the time given that the energy is 75 joule. Okay, keluarkan formula untuk energy. Ada satu formula saja, E is equal to IVT. This is what we want. So since dia adalah true resistor number 3, maksudnya dekat sini adalah V3, this one adalah I3. And then you just masukkanlah 75 equal to I3 tadi 0.25 times with V3 is 6 volt times with T. So T will be equal to
Fifty second.
50 second. Okay, semua dapat 50 second.
Dapat, Miss.
Dapat, Miss.
Okay, Aiman ada? I don't see nama Aiman. Aiman tidak. Okay, never mind. Okay, ada soalan so far?
So far jelas, Miss.
So far jelas.
Ada, Miss.
Okay, untuk potentiometer, okay. Untuk power and energy pun okay. Okay, so untuk tutorial kita sudah bincang soalan yang kamu belum buat. So, maksudnya siaplah sudah tutorial 3 kita. Untuk yang belum hantar tu, please hantar by today. Okay, because Miss akan bagi another kerja lagi. So kalau kamu tangguhkan sahaja kerja-kerja kamu ni and then Miss tambah lagi, tambah bila lah kamu buat kan benda-benda yang lain tu, kerja-kerja yang lain. So tolong siapkan kerja kamu sebab untuk kelas esok, okay, Miss akan bagi soalan extra question lah untuk potentiometer. So untuk latih kamu untuk solvekan that type of question. So kalau Miss explain saja kamu tidak buat, it's useless, it's pointless if you don't do it on your own. So nanti Miss akan bagi untuk kelas esok, okay, kita tidak akan ada Google Meet. Kita akan, kamu akan buat latihan sahaja. And then untuk hari Sabtu, okay, hari Sabtu kita ada kelas gantian ikut jadual hari Isnin. I think jadual hari Isnin kalau tidak silap. Kalau jadual hari Isnin kita hanya ada 1 jam sahaja. That one I haven't planned for that class yet. Miss, I'm not sure lagi mau masuk chapter 4 kah atau macam mana. Tapi sebagai persediaan, kamu just print saja dahulu nota untuk chapter 4. So Miss sudah upload nota untuk chapter 4. So semua boleh print lah sebagai persediaan. If I decide to do the class, if I decide to enter new chapter on Saturday, that one I will tell you later. Okay, so jangan lupa Isnin malam kita ada UPS 1. Please buat revision. Ada 20 soalan. Soalan objektif dan kita akan buat online saja. Okay, there will be no face-to-face UPS. So soalan revision untuk untuk UPS 1 ada di dalam GC. Miss sudah upload the link for that Google form. So tolonglah buat revision for that one. I'm pretty sure it will help you a lot. So soalan dia adalah soalan seperti UPS lah. Okay. So itu sahaja untuk kelas hari ni. So kita sudah habis chapter 3. Besok Miss akan bagi latihan untuk potentiometer. Any last question before we end our class?
No, Miss.
No, Miss.
Okay. So kalau tiada, I guess that's all for today. I'll see you in our next class. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss.
Thank you, Miss.
Thank you, Miss.
You're welcome.